Tables League Challenge.
Get Shrek.
Is this an ace?
Professor Brock. No. Versus Professor Scumlord.
Scumbag.
Scumbag, I'm sorry. Look out for the remix.
Get good, scrub.
Commentary is going to start soon, so yeah. Bye.
All right, you guys have 30 minutes plus 3 turns. Have fun.
Oh, I'm glad I'm not going first so I can eat it in.
Exactly what happened in the first match. No, I actually held on to it because I had a real good hand except for the end. keep this in 12.
Brock, what's going on? What kind of garbage list is this?
It's only 4 basics. No time for
it. Is it the Panzone Pizza and Calzone special?
This is my list, but he's probably going to be mine.
No talent play?
No talent play.
Alright guys, so, as they're getting set up, just wanted to keep a little clip in there, thought it was funny. Anyway, while they're getting set up, Mr. Brock, Professor Brock, is playing his Greninja deck with no Talonflames, as you heard, only 4 Froakies. It is a lot more consistent, or a little bit more consistent, without Talonflames, just running the 4 Froakies, but as you can see, your opponent racks up the Mulligans, and if they had a bad start, then, well, they kind of go against it. And then, our good buddy, Professor Scumbag, Scrublord, something along those lines. He is running Volcanion Flareon, I believe. With Flareon, I should say. So, it looks as though he's at a disadvantage, but you'll see later on. This is actually a very close battle. Not sure why it was so close, but it was. So, it seems like they're starting now, so I will cut here, and if I need to commentate over anything, well, I guess I will. That's my job.
Draw.
So, Brock is going to go ahead and start his turn. Looks like Professor Scrublord. He put a Bursting Balloon on his active Froakie. Then he's going to play a Dive Ball. Search your deck for a water-type Pokemon. Any water-type Pokemon, to be exact. And as I was saying, Professor Scrublord got a Baby Volcanion and another Baby Volcanion and a Volcanion EX and a Flareon EX. Probably with some help of those Mulligans. And Brock is going to go ahead and take the Froakie. As you guys can tell, I'm very skilled at this commentating thing. So he's going to go ahead and shuffle his deck. And so as you guys can tell, it is a water deck versus a fire deck. Well, also a fire water deck. But so it looks as though Brock has the upper hand here, just with the type advantage. I don't know. Brock's going to go ahead and attach the splash energy to his benched Froakie. Sorry about the glare there, guys. It was a little bit on the spot, and lighting was a bit weird. So, Professor Scumlord is going ahead and start his turn. Going to attach a Fighting Fury Belt to his active Baby Volcanion, which lets it do 10 more damage and gives it 40 more HP. So that is pretty snazzy. He's going to go ahead and attach a fire energy to that Volcanion. And, well, see what he's going to do next. Play a Max Elixir. Look at the top 6 cards of your deck and attach a basic energy you find there to one of your basic bench Pokemon. So, pretty snazzy. So Professor Scumlord is going to go ahead and Lysander up the benched Froakie, the one that doesn't have the Bursting Balloon, and bring up the one with the Splash Energy, which allows you to return all the Pokemon that have the Splash Energy attached to it. So let's say that gets knocked out, he can return the Froakie back to his hand. If that was a Frogadier and it gets knocked out, he's able to return the Frogadier and Froakie back to his hand. And looks like Scumlord is going to go ahead and Power Heater for 60, which knocked it out because it brought its power up from 30 to 60 thanks to Steam Up on that Volcanion EX. And Brock is going to get Level Ball for a Frogadier. This sounds like it's very out of time, but I am just very slow with talking, or very fast, I don't know. So thanks to that Splash Energy, Brock is going to go ahead and bench that Froakie and is going to play an Ace Trainer, which, if you don't know, is a draw supporter card. which is not very commonly seen, mostly only seen in Greninja decks, which allows you to have both you and your opponent shuffle your hands into your decks if you have more prize cards remaining than your opponent. Your opponent draws 3 and you draw 6, so very cool. So thanks to that Ace Chainer, Brock is going to bring Professor Scumlord down to a hand of 3 and bring himself up to a big hand of 6. So, let's see what he'll get from there. Looks like he's gonna bench another Froakie. And pass the turn. Which is surprising because Greninja usually runs a fair amount of energies, so the fact they didn't hit one is quite surprising, actually. So Professor Scumlord, one of those two, is going to start off his turn attaching a basic fire energy to his benched baby Volcanion, and then is going to steam up on his benched Volcanion EX, and is going to follow that up with a Max Elixir, which he whiffs hard. Very hard. So, no energy for him. Poor Professor Scumlord. Not really, because nobody loves him. Oh, and out of nowhere, Professor Scumlord comes back with a Ned. Which, if you don't know, you and your opponent both shuffle their hands like Ace Trainer. But both of you draw cards equal to the amount of your prize cards. More or less, Ace Trainer is like Ned. So, so as of right now, it looks like Professor Scumlord, so I'm just going to call him Scumlord for now on, is going to be drawing 5 because he knocked out the Froakie, and Brock's going to be drawing 6. So, Professor Scumlord's gonna go ahead and Ultra Ball for something. Discarding Sycamore and I think another Ultra Ball. Gonna grab another Volcanion EX. So, if you guys want to see a Volcanion deck list, might be outdated now, but check the iCard. If you guys want to see our deck list of that. Alright, so Scumlord's gonna go ahead and drop the Shaman. Using setup, drawing 5, I believe. Which, well, it's Shaman. So, there is a reason why it is a lot of money. So, with that, he's going to go ahead and Max Elixir. I believe that's his third Max Elixir. Really hit it? Nope, he's going to whiff that one too, sadly. So, not sure what's up with that, because Volcanion also runs a lot of energy. So, no reason why he should be missing those. I bet it's just a bad match. Not match, but, you know, you have those games where you just can't get what you need. So, then he's going to go ahead and steam up for a second time, adding 60 damage to his Baby Volcanion's power heater. And I believe that's what he's going to do. He's going to go ahead and knock out that Frogadier, take another prize card, and attach a fire energy to his Volcanion EX, and I believe 1-2 Flareon too. So, now it is Brock's turn. Brock's going to start off his turn playing a Dive Ball. A little hesitant there. JK lol, he knew what he was doing. He's going to go ahead and search for a Frogadier and evolve his active Froakie. Probably going to try to get off those water dupes as you do playing Greninja. And then Brock is going to go ahead and VS Seeker for Ace Trainer. And play Ace Trainer, and now we hear some amazing words from Scumlord.
Try to get your channel flagged.
Here, don't edit this out. I'm afraid of no Ace Trainer, because Professor Scumbag lives on the edge. Professor Scumbag lives on the edge. Lives on the edge. I'm afraid of no Ace Trainer.
Make sure you guys remember that if you're ever facing Professor Scumlord.
Lives on the edge.
It looks like they are still shuffling, trying to draw their hands. Not trying to, but you know what I mean. It's very hard to commentate on things like this and make it interesting. But, well, maybe you don't. Who knows? This is very new. The first battle I've commentated over. Maybe I'll have another one up Sunday of a Super Slaughter Sunday where Steuben completely destroys me in a deck. Not what? What? In a game at a prior league challenge. Just haven't gotten around to doing anything with it. So Brock is going to go ahead and attach a splash energy to that Frogadier! And yeah. Looks like he's probably going to Water Dupes. He might have something to do before that though. So he's going to go ahead and put Silent Lab out, which makes it so no basic Pokemon on the field have abilities. So very, very interesting. I'm going to go ahead and Water Dupes, and it's going to be Scumlord's turn. So he's going to go ahead and draw. See what he can get. He's going to go ahead and play a Trainer's Mail, which lets you choose a trainer card that is not Trainer's Mail from the top four cards of your deck. Shuffle afterward. He's going to go ahead and take, I believe, a Faded Town, if I saw that correctly. Yep, it is a Faded Town, which will counteract. Doesn't do anything against Brock's deck, but it counteracts the stadium, which is all Rob needs. So, he's going to go ahead and play another Trainer's Mail. Very tough decision, apparently. And he's going to go ahead and take the Sycamore and shuffle his deck as you do. SL's going to go ahead and play the Sycamore he just got from the Trainer's Mail, which lets you, of course, discard your hand and draw 7 cards. He's going to follow that up using Steam Up twice, discarding 2 Fire Energies from his hand, which now lets his Baby Volcanion hit for 90 damage. And he's going to go ahead and Power Heater for the KO on the active Frogadier. But the Frogadier and Froakie, of course, go back to Brock's hand because of the Splash Energy. Brock's going to go ahead and start his turn. He's going to evolve his active Frogadier and his bench Frogadier into Greninjas, and he's going to evolve his bench Froakie into a Frogadier. And he's going to attach for turn onto the active. Bench another Froakie, and VS Seeker for...
I'm afraid of no Ace Trainer. Alright, now you can stop playing Ace Trainer. I'm afraid of no Ace Trainer.
He lives on the edge.
Living on the edge. Up a song, copyrighted song. Now you don't get revenue.
Every time you say edge, I'm going to put a picture of N on the screen.
I think elite challenge is Nick. I think elite challenge is first?
Yeah.
Wait. I think it's like... 1 o'clock?
Yeah.
No,
Do you bounce the energy for 60?
What's that?
Well, you can bounce the energy for 60, for 80. For 80.
Yeah. You got 107 hit points out. Sure. Yeah, 4 damage. Let's do a Shadow Stitcher.
So it's 40 and no abilities, right?
No commentary is best commentary.
Yeah.
I'll just steam artillery for the 30.
Sure.
Is it first time?
No.
No, no energy.
What's that, Rob?
No energy.
No, I know. You were starting to say something.
Oh, for the first time you get to put damage on this.
I know, right?
Dude, you have an ace trainer and, like, a pro. Professor Scumbag lives on the edge. Why is this deck even still playable?
No water shirt. Sure.
Give a dislike for Greninja.
Well, yeah, of course. Of course! Why not?
Only supportive,
the only thing you've played all game What, you play eight of them?
Here, I'll play that clip over here. He doesn't care about Ace Trainer.
And then you need to play the point where I'm just like, why not? Just clearly it's just like, I hate Ace Trainer.
Every time they keep the speaker speak.
Good old Ace Trainer.
I'll fling my card.
Wow, wow, wee, wow.
Oh, and then you don't cut my deck.
Retreat?
Of course. Yes, red, red. Free retreat. Not broken at all. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. I hate you, Brug. Absolutely.
No! Not again! Never, ever again!
Hey, now play nice.
I just want to let you know that the hate is real. Chill,
yeah.
Why are you letting Sheen in there?
Why did Sheen? Four bases. Four donkey.
This is where I should just play that, like, one of, like, Garbodor. Be like, my own abilities, I don't care. Yeah. Take my two cards.
One card for turn.
No, it's two cards.
Oh, okay. Looked like one prize card was left.
That could be worse.
My bad.
Silly Steuben, tricks are for kids.
Bring them all out. You know, I'm not gonna lie, I probably couldn't handle any more overrun at this point. The Greninjas just won't end. I can't believe this is a downtown one. The ballsiest, riskiest move ever. I kind of want to do it. But at the same time, I kind of don't. No, I think I need to not play the super ballsy maneuver. Probably isn't my best.
It's not super ball, it's a great ball.
Probably not my best play. Let's go ahead and Lysander up one of the Froakies. And then I'll Blaze Ball for the KO. Yeah, it's a good thing I didn't go for that ballsy move. Set up for 4.
And that is time. Active player finish turn. Take 3 additional turns as needed.
Okay. Good.
Alright guys, so it is after time. I decided not to commentate up to this point because they were doing pretty well of explaining what they were doing and such. But anyway, that is time. Well, time a while ago, actually. It's turn two of three. And Professor Scrublord just lies ended up the Froakie. Now, for some reason, Brock couldn't hit any of his energies to be able to, with the last turn, with the last Sycamore, he couldn't hit any of his energies before, and now that the Froakie is active, he's going to have to retreat and also be able to somehow get out the damage he needs to attack, so I'm not sure how else is going to go, but there's his energies, of course, now that he, well, can't really use them.
Oh, my God.
And, well, I'll just let the rest.
Rob has been, like, super killed.
Oh, Salt's building. That was turn three, is it now? We're tied. Yeah, I was literally, like, I had... Then, was that... Ah! Why? Why? Ah!
Ah! Calm yourself, please.
Dude, that's my hand, and that's the rest of my deck.
Zooms it straight in his face.
Whiffing that energy was ridiculous.
Yeah. Dude, good game! Oh my gosh!
I was just like, oh, I got it, because I was trying to get the BS secret.
I thought that Beta Town was in your hand.
I was trying to get the BS secret, and I couldn't get it, and I was just like, I had the Lion Standard there, and I was like,
how many stadiums are you on?
Three.
Wow, I didn't expect a third.
Man.
Professor Scrubbag.
Yeah, pretty much. Dude,
do you have any words? Greninja's
trash. I hate Greninja. It's dumb.
Is that your message to the viewers?
Yeah, the message is, once again, we're in another format that's trash. I'd rather deal with Nightmarge again than deal with this.
Confirming that Professor Scrubbag lost.
What?
No, it's Ty.
Shut up. Yeah.
Hey now, don't talk to players that way.
He's a player.
Why is there like 30 codes over here? Man, that was such a good game.
That was good.
That was such a good game. I totally thought I was going to lose that.
That was pretty clutch. That, if you would have hit one energy on that Sycamore on turn two, you would have been game.
Yeah, I know. And I was like, I bet you anything he won't hit it out of irony. And then I'm like, I'm going to win. And you lay down Silent Lab and I'm like, I'm going to lose.
So yeah, that was a pretty epic match between Brock and Rob there, a.k.a. Professor Scrublord. Now because of, you know, stuff. But yeah, I'd like to thank both of them for letting me record their battle. This was Top Tables, the last round of a League Challenge at Infinite Consortium. So, if you guys like this Battle Frenzy Friday, make sure you leave a lick and comment down below what your thoughts are on, well, Greninja and Volcanion. And maybe we'll do a Greninja deck profile sometime soon and have another battle. So, my name is Master Jigglypuff. Thank you all very much for watching. Make sure you guys subscribe for daily Pokemon videos such as vlogs, live streams, pack openings, and this weekend we are going to a Sun and Moon pre-release. We're going to be getting a booster box, a ton of packs, and going to record a fun vlog. So make sure you stay tuned, and we'll see you guys next time.